Well, Dr. Death is letting Kevin Sullivan know what he thinks of him to start out, and in turn, we're taking a look at the World Television Champion Mike Rotunda, who's giving his feelings on Dr. Death Steve Williams. You're at a disadvantage when you go in against the varsity club if you go in by yourself, because there's always one, maybe two. And even now with Gary Hart kind of tied into the varsity club, there could be even more than two at ringside, Jim.
You're certainly right. And, of course, that man I don't think needs any help to fight his battles. He's a great athlete. Mike Rotunda
started for the Syracuse Orangemen in football, a defensive tackle,
as a heavyweight wrestler for the Orangemen. Of course, Dr. Death started offensive guard for the Oklahoma Sooners in football and was a four-time All-American in wrestling. So these guys' careers certainly parallel each other. As Dr. Death very quickly comes back into the ring, Doc, big football tackle, down goes Rotunda. The offense got the better of the defense in that particular collision.
It was a great one. It really cleared out the hole for a would-be running back. There's no doubt about that. Knocked him right to the seat of his pants.
The University of Oklahoma has averaged like 500 yards total offense, and about 488 of it comes on the ground. And Dr. Death, during those years, was one of the reasons for that. He and the great offensive line. There you see Mike Rotunda talking to Kevin Sullivan. Was Sullivan involved in the situation with Dusty Rhodes and the dog collar matchup that we've been talking about earlier in the hour? Sullivan here at ringside. Dr. Death, not intimidated by Sullivan's presence. But you have to be, Tony, I think, very aware that he is there. How can you forget Kevin Sullivan as he roams at ringside, knowing that he has been involved and has interfered in match after match in Mike Rotunda's benefit?
Side headlock from Dr. Death, Steve Williams. You may have noticed, fans, maybe not, that in the corner for Kevin Sullivan is a jump rope. Looks like an old heavy-duty electrical cord that he brings to the ring to do his jumping. His jump rope calisthenics or whatever he does to start out, but also that is used, and we know, is used as a weapon. And we may see it come into play in this match.
Rotunda complaining that Dr. Death used the point of the elbow, and whether he did or he did not, it's legal. So, Tommy Young, great official. Rotunda got his answer and didn't say much more. Collar and elbow tie-up. Williams and Rotunda, side headlock by Williams, waist lock by Mike Rotunda. And big Dr. Death, 283 pounds.
Rotunda will back him to the ropes, and Doc now will let him back up, possibly, as Tommy Young calls for the break. Let's see if we get a clean one. No, sir. And knee went right firmly to the midsection, and Rotunda, with that uppercut of his, which is a fine blow against Doc, really now, but Doc returns the favor, and here's his forte, Jim Ross, the power that is only Steve Williams and the press. A couple of times high above the head.
Military pressing Mike Rotunda. And that is quite, I mean, quite a feat when you really stop and think about it. We're not just flipping a stationary, an inanimate barbell, or a Nautilus, using a Nautilus machine. You're talking about live weight, having to balance it and muscling it up those five times that Doc Military pressed it. I can remember a match, Tony, back during the Great American Bash where Dr. Death military pressed Arn Anderson, who weighs 270 at that time. Doc Military pressed him 10 times, which is a little bit hard to believe. But I was there, I saw it, it actually happened. And Mike Rotunda, I'm sure, would agree that Dr. Death just may be the strongest man he's ever got his hands on thus far in the NWA.
I think he has a legitimate shot, and there's a lot of competition out there. This is by no means slighting the Road Warriors or Lex Luger or anybody like that, but Doc may be the strongest man in the sport.
He certainly may be, and I know one thing. I guess I'm very partial because I've known him so long, and both of us coming, of course, Doc recruited by University of Oklahoma from the state of Colorado, and coming into the state of Oklahoma, I met Dr. Death. I've known him for a long time. A lot of ups and downs, a lot of professional challenges, a lot of personal challenges. But Dr. Death is one man that knows what he wants. I think he knows that he has got to train harder than he's ever trained. He's got to be more intense than he's ever been to regain that plateau, that championship level that he has performed on in the past. He wants to be there again.
Continues to hold on to the side headlock.
The The side headlock continues, and now as Rotunda tries to get out of it, a great reversal, trying to put the big arms down. But you know, Jim, when you try to go strength for strength against Steve Williams, you're really playing his ballgame.
You certainly are. The way you got to beat Dr. Death Steve Williams is with quickness and a quick hitting 1-2-3 count. Not something that you've got to, he's not going to submit. You're not going to outpower him. You've got to beat him with a quick wrestling maneuver. Rotunda has that ability. Dr. Death, high cross body press. Tommy Young down, and we've got a two count as this tremendous crowd here in Charlotte, North Carolina, looks on here at the outdoors at the Charlotte Memorial Stadium. Side headlock by Williams, taking Rotunda over. Young down, near fall situation there. A two count, and now Dr. Death controlling this match. Doc, a big bruise there, and you can see on his right arm here, his right bicep. This sport takes its toll on people. I can remember Dr. Death having 108 stitches in his eye from an injury at a television taping, and believe it or not, that's about 4 or 5 years ago. His opponent in that match was Brad Armstrong.
Down goes Steve Williams from a low blow, apparently from Mike Rotunda. And one advantage the Doc had is momentarily thwarted as the champion now walks around. It's moves like this that, of course, help Rotunda keep that world television title.
No matter how tough somebody is, there's always a chink in the armor, so to speak, and Dr. Death now, nail on the outside. What has Sullivan got?
He has a sledgehammer, and he's pounding away, a sledgehammer for goodness sakes, pounding away first at the shoulder and now at the hip of Steve Williams. At the hip.
Anything that is not nailed down or hidden is just apt to be used as a weapon by Kevin Sullivan. And I've seen guys have foreign objects used on them before, but I've never seen anybody get a sledgehammer used on them. And there's that jump rope. Williams is being choked there by Rotunda, coming right in front of our camera here.
Right down to the grass, the sod around the outside, and choking Steve Williams is Kevin Sullivan. You know, basically, if the NWA would look at some videotape highlights, which they usually don't, but of something like this, you could really ban Kevin Sullivan for life for using a sledgehammer, because he doesn't want to. Look, he's going to pick it up again. He's not worried about winning the match here. He really wants to injure this guy, put him out of wrestling.
He's not worried about his future. He's not. Gosh! Sledgehammer right in the back. Dr. Death Steve Williams. The workmen were, when they were putting the scaffolding up and erecting the ring here, if they left any tools out, we've seen him use lumber. We've seen him use that golden spike, but never something as potentially fatal as a sledgehammer. And there's a big chop by Mike Rotunda. I don't care. Dr. Death, in my opinion, is the toughest man in professional wrestling, bar none. But how much more can even he take?
Stomping away at Steve Williams, and it's a wonder he was even standing up momentarily. Now we're going to take a look at Kevin Sullivan. He has one of those pins that hooks the steel railing together in his right hand. He reached down along the steel railing and just pulled it out from the top there. It is a steel pin. Look at it. And he jabs him right in the back of the neck with it.
Sullivan has... His day is coming. With Dusty Rhodes and that chain, Sullivan says he likes pain, and but I don't know of anybody that's get physically assaulted with a log chain. I mean, that just doesn't make any kind of common sense whatsoever. But I guess Sullivan hasn't made a lot of sense in several years. There's a pinning predicament by Dr. Death. Rotunda kicks out, though, very quickly.
Rotunda now will send him over once again. Steve Williams stumbled that time. I believe maybe he hit the scaffolding, maybe the back of the head, that steel scaffold going up on either side of the ring, hit it with the back of his head, and he just went right straight down.
Tommy Young down very quickly for a two count. Dr. Death has met the steel in this one. The steel scaffolding, and more specifically, that sledgehammer that Sullivan used on him just a few moments earlier. This match for the World Television Championship. And Rotunda has a referee in the position that he wants him in.
You know, it's apparent that Rotunda is not in much danger of losing his title as long as Sullivan is there. Of course, something could happen to change things, but Sullivan is always going to give him that extra advantage, even more so than most managers I've seen in this sport. Sullivan is more involved physically than anybody, and that's including a James J. Dillon or even a Jim Cornette.
Well, I think it's a tip-off of exactly their mood and their philosophy when it comes to their matches, and I think it's a tip-off to what is in store for Rhodes when Sullivan wrestles Rhodes in that dog collar matchup, because you know Gary Hart at some time is going to get involved if he has the opportunity. Dr. Death is fighting with everything he can to not go down, to not weaken any further.
There's no doubt they have hit him with basically everything they could think of. Steve Williams getting another wind right here. Both arms are up. He comes up. Nothing that Rotunda can do but go up with him. And basically, Williams carried him around the ring now. Two elbow shots to the midsection. And Rotunda goes down, hands on knees. But he comes across with a great clothesline move to take down Steve Williams. Great counter move by the champion.
Great wrestling move by Mike Rotunda. Dropping the leg on the chest of Dr. Death Steve Williams. Moves to the lateral press. Great binds the leg. And Tommy Young got a two count out of it. Rotunda would like to, for the official to count it faster. But that's not the way it's done. There's a backbreaker by Mike Rotunda. And now Rotunda going to the outside. We don't see this too often. He takes very few risks, very few chances. That's not his style right here. He's having a word with Tommy Young, and Dr. Death is up. This one may backfire on Rotunda.
Rotunda waited too long. He said something to a fan or two climbing up, then to Tommy Young, and enabled the Doc to come up again, and now the big man from Oklahoma is a storming. Right hand to the side of the head, sending to the other side, and a high back drop. Steve Williams, enabling the champion to get up. Watch out here, it could be a drop kick. And it is 280-plus pounds up in the air, that time horizontally.
Doc can beat you on the ground or in the air, and now body slam by Dr. Death. Lateral press. Doc breaking his game plan there a little bit. I thought he might go for the stampede. Down to that football tackle, explodes out of the blocks. And Dr. Death now controlling Rotunda, but there's a mistake. Rotunda, we talked about that he had to be quicker than Dr. Death and get that quick 1-2-3. There was some quickness right there, and Young, Tommy Young just ran over. He was not quick enough to get out of the way of Rotunda, and Tommy Young is in a bad condition right here, as Rotunda, likewise, is in jeopardy of losing the championship.
Scoop slam puts him down, and there's nobody to count. In addition, Sullivan is holding Tommy Young down.
Sullivan's holding Tommy Young down until Rotunda has the opportunity to break the maneuver. There you see Tommy Young, Dr. Death trying to get Young to shake out of it.
And Rotunda over the top. He threw him over the top rope down onto the ground.
That's an automatic disqualification. Dr. Death, in the heat of the battle here, just elevated Rotunda all the way over the top rope. That's going to be a disqualification for the doctor. But apparently he has not realized that. And Dr. Death Steve Williams, one more time with a pinning predicament. Look at Sullivan, manhandling Tommy Young.
And Teddy Long comes in.
Teddy Long did not see Dr. Death throw Rotunda over the top rope. The match is already officially over in that capacity. Rotunda's going to retain the title via disqualification. But Dr. Death looks to have won the battle here, but not the war.
Tommy Young letting know the verdict. DQ, and the Doc will relinquish that title back to Mike Rotunda. We'll be back, fans.